Welcome to this Q&A of the day video in association with TLC Electrical Wholesaler, renowned for quality, value and customer service. Today's question relates to the EV charging equipment from Replenishh featured in one of our recent videos. The question is, do I need to be trained to install electric vehicle charging based on the recent OLEV changes? Now, this probably raises further questions in your mind, such as, has there even been recent OLEV changes? Well, there has. The Office for Low Emission Vehicles have recently made some adjustments to their grant scheme for installing EV charge points. Now, back in September, an email was sent out to all OLEV installers outlining the major changes. It's worth noting, first of all, that the following applies only to the home charge scheme, not to the workplace scheme, which remains unaffected. In essence, the changes are mostly clerical and are designed to streamline the rather complex process of claiming the grant following installation. So it's good news, really. However, there is one adjustment that's been made that needs putting into context, and that is the removal of the need to be approved by a manufacturer to install their equipment. Up until now, manufacturers of OLEV approved EV equipment have had to approve the installer carrying out the installation work. This was generally carried out by means of training courses run by the manufacturers. Now, however, with this approval no longer being required, it begs the question, will training still be required? Well, we really need to step back from this one situation and look at the big picture. The electrical work carried out in the UK needs to, by law, be carried out to the electricity at work regs. They are the law. While we know that BS 7671 is not a statutory document, compliance with it provides compliance with the law. Regulation 134.1 in BS 7671 states that good workmanship by one or more skilled or instructed persons and proper materials shall be used in the erection of the electrical installation. We find similar wording in Regulation 132.1 in connection with design and in 134.2.1 in connection with initial verification. These words apply to all electrical installations. And a skilled person is defined in BS 7671 as a person who possesses, as appropriate to the nature of the electrical work to be undertaken, adequate education, training, and practical skills, and who is able to perceive risks and avoid hazards which electricity can create. Really, the question you need to ask yourself is, if something's gone wrong with your installation of an EV charger, how would you legally prove and evidence that you are educated and trained in this area of electrical work? EV charger installation is still a relatively new and rapidly developing area of the regs. A case in point is how quickly the first amendment to the 18th edition had to be released just to take account of the development of EV charging technology in a very short period of time. As we said at the outset, the workplace charge scheme isn't changing. Approval from manufacturers of EV chargers will still be required to get the OLEV grant for workplace installations. So if manufacturers continue to offer training for their products, why would you not take it? Why would you not go on a dedicated EV training course? There isn't really a good reason not to. So in short, the removal of manufacturer approval from the OLEV home charge scheme does not remove the need for training on EV charger installation. Thank you very much for watching.